Welcome. Today we will discuss what is the difference between neutral and earth. Earth is also called ground. Here I have shown one valve socket which has three terminal. Earth, big one is earth, right one is called line and left one is called neutral. So earth and neutral have separate connections. These three are here. Here you are seeing six. This outer three are for 15 ampere plug and remaining three are for 5 ampere plug. Here you see in the socket L is written, that is line. This is line terminal. Here neutral is written. So this line terminal is this. This is this. Similarly in this plug, here L is written, very small size. Here neutral is written. So this L line, if you connect, will go, this L will go here. Now in this plug, earth pin is thicker and longer. It is thick because earth wire used will be always thick to reduce the resistance. And it is longer because if you connect this plug in the socket, then first earth connection should be made, then only line and neutral for safety. Now this is AC supply. From generator, connection will come to substation. From substation, two wire will come, line and neutral. And this is load in our house. And this is earth point of the socket. I have made no connection here, only load is shown. Now here you see, same supply, same load. But this earth point I have connected to earth. This is green color. Earth wire is shown using green color. At this side, supply side, neutral itself is connected to earth. So there is a difference. In supply side, neutral itself is connected. This side, earth and neutral no connection. Earth wire, earth point is connected to earth. This connection is made by going 8 to 10 feet inside earth and using copper plate, some pipes and charcoals. Now, these wires are very long. They will have some resistance. Suppose this resistance is 0.5 ohm and 10 ampere current is flowing. So here 5 volt drop will be there. So if this is 0 volt, this point will not be 0 volt, this will be 5 volt and this is 0. The voltage of neutral and earth will not be same. Now I will measure the voltage of neutral. This is my house supply. Now we will measure the voltage between neutral and earth. This is earth, this is line, this is neutral. So neutral voltage with respect to earth is about 2.7 volt. Actually it will change with load. In evening it will be higher. Now I will measure voltage of line with respect to earth. This comes 245 volt. Now I will measure voltage of line with respect to neutral, 242 volt. The line voltage with respect to neutral is only 242. With respect to earth, it is higher, 245 volt. So line voltage will not be same with respect to neutral and earth. Here I have shown three-phase diagram. This is substation transformer. This is primary, this is secondary. Primary gets high voltage supply. Using step-down transformer, we get low voltage. In India, we get 240 volt here between phase A and neutral. Like that, there will be three phases. So how supply will go between A and N? A line and neutral. So how they divide in three parts? To one part, they will give from A and neutral. To another, they will give B and neutral. And third set, they will give C and neutral. Now this line wire is coming. This neutral wire is coming. This is point of coupling at house. this side is house. So we get line wire and neutral wire. This is socket, what I have shown earlier. Earth, line, neutral. So this line wire using a switch comes to line. Then there is a load is connected outside and neutral goes to neutral. Now earth, no earth wire comes from here. This neutral will go to earth, but no earth wire here. So we create a earth here, earth wire, and this point we connect to earth. This is plate inside for proper connection. Now here I have shown only one. Suppose there are two. So connection will be like this. This is one, this is two. So this line wire will go to both ends using two separate switch. Here also. Similarly, neutral wire will be shorted and connected to neutral. We have only one L and one N. And earth wala point, we short inside and the single wire will come here and goes here. So earth point is created, neutral and line we get from service station. Now we will learn why earthing. Earthing is done both way, power supply side also, load side also. First we will learn why power supply earthing, why. Here I have shown secondary of the transformer. This phase voltage is 240 volt. The neutral is not connected to earth support. Now what happens? We know the voltage across this, but we don't know the voltage of this point with respect to earth. It is called the floating system. Suppose some lightning or switching impulse comes, this point may go to very high voltage, so this equipment may fail. Because voltage of this point with respect to earth is not known. Only across this is known. Here, neutral is connected to earth. So this point has become 0 volt. Now we know voltage of this point is 0 with respect to earth. Here it was not known. Voltage of this point with respect to earth is 240 volt. The voltage of each point is fixed or known with respect to earth. So this is safe system. Here equipment will fail. Here equipment will not fail. So power supply side earthing is done to protect the equipment. Now we will learn earthing why at load side. Now why earthing? I have shown one electrical equipment, say oven or heater, and we are touching this and somehow there is a fault. So because of fault, here a supply side neutral is connected to earth. So because of fault, current will flow like this. Circuit is complete and we get the shock because current is flowing through our body and our body resistance is more. Even full 240 volt will come, current flow will be less, shock will be there, but this current may not be sufficient to blow the fuse. Now here, same equipment is here, load is connected across line and neutral and body is connected to earth. Now same thing is shown here. This body is connected to earth and that is grounded. Now if here fault comes, then current will flow like this or like this. No current will go here, so we will be safe, there will not be any shock. This voltage will be zero, here full voltage was coming. And because of shorting, heavy current will flow, so this fuse also will blow. The main purpose of earthing is safety. We learn that earthing is required for safety. Now suppose we connect a load across line and earth, then what problem will come? This is supply side, transformer secondary. I have told these are three houses, group. They are divided in three parts. One group gets the power from A, another gets from B, third set gets from C. Neutral will be common. Here I have shown together, actually it will be like this. C See here, this is one set, this is another set, this is third set. This set is giving power from A, neutral. This one, C and neutral. This one, B and neutral. Now neutral gets current from all three faces. Suppose this current is 10 ampere peak. So here current will flow this 10 sin omega t. In phase B, this current will be this 120 degree phase shifted. And in C phase, current will be this 240 degree phase shifted. If these currents are equal, loads are equal, phase shifts are correct. If you add this all three, it will come zero. The neutral current will be wireless or zero, it will be zero, provided it is perfect balance. But generally, this wire will have some resistance, this wire will have some resistance, this point will not be common. The neutral will have some current, but very less. Now these three loads, which are connected to neutral, are shown here. 1, 2, 3. Now suppose this current is approximately zero, it is very less. Suppose this load we connect between line and earth. I will connect. Now load is connected between line and earth. Now you see this current is not going to neutral. So neutral current will not be zero. There will be unbalance. Some voltage will be more, some voltage will be less. This may have high voltage or low voltage, this may have high voltage, low voltage, or this may have. So because of this disturbance, some component may fail. Further, if there is some motor connected and unbalance is there, then motor will get heated up. Earthing system are many types, like TN type, TNC type, TNS type, TNCS type, TT type, and IT type. Now which one to be followed depends upon application as per standard. Your load application may be single phase load, may be three phase load, may be high voltage, may be HVDC. HVDC earthing is quite complex. May be medium voltage or industrial load or some other. Today we will close here itself.